humble pranams. At the lotus feet of our beloved master, Balwan Sri Satya Sai Baba. When your heart is full, language becomes very poor medium to express your feelings. What we experienced the last 11 days is nothing but a divine ecstasy. For all those devotees of Bhagwan, we all know that Bhagwan has been performing these yajnas from almost more than 5 decades. Every Dasara, we would have Veda Purusha Saptah Ajnana Yajna in the very divine presence of our Bhagwan. 2006, we had a unique opportunity to have ATHI RUDRA MAHAA YAGNAM in Prashant Nilaya, in the very divine presence of our Bhagavan. In 2007, we were blessed with a similar opportunity at Chennai, in the very immediate presence of Bhagavan. Again, in his own abode, Vrindavan, we have witnessed one more ATHI RUDRA MAHAA YAGNAM, so wonderfully done. 2006-2007, Bhagavan was physically present. But this time, did any one of us feel the absence of Swami here? Did any of us feel that Bhagavan is not here? I think all those who attended definitely will agree with me that we felt Bhagavan at every second in this wonderful Vrindavan ashram during all the 11 days. This morning, it was emotionally, I recollected, after morning harati, I could feel as if Swami just gone back to Trayi Vrindavan. That was the feeling which was absolutely present in every heart of every devotee present here in this morning. What a divine experience. Who can create this experience except our Bhagavan? Today we may not be able to see his physical form, but there are lakhs of devotees for Bhagavan who have never seen him. What is it then? There are lakhs of devotees all over the world who have never seen him, but they are very, very devoted to Swami. For them, Swami means it's only a photograph or a video. They have not come to Prashant Nilayam. Some of them could not afford to come to Prashant Nilayam, see physically, but they have been devotees for 20 years, 30 years, all over the world. For them, it doesn't make any difference. Few of us who have come here, seen that wonderful, beautiful form, do miss it. But today, it is a reconnect. This ATHI RUDRA MAHAA YAGNAM has again brought back the wonderful memories of Bhagavan in this lovely Vrindavan, close to every devotee's heart and close to everybody who knows Vrindavan. It is very useful for human mind to forget about the divine aspect of Bhagavan. We have seen even in Rama avatar, even in Krishna avatar, Rama was just 14 years old when he lifted Shiva Dhanus and he wielded the Shiva Dhanus. He was just hardly 14 years old. After he took the hand of Mother Sita, he goes back, and what did the people do? They sent him to forest. Everybody knew that Rama is none other than Parameshwara who could wield the Shiva Dhanus. That is why Mother Sita's hand was given to Rama. Entire Ayodhya knew it. But what did they do? Finally, human mind tends to mundane things. When it comes to our own thing, we think of kingdoms, we think of everything, but we forget what the reality is. Lord Krishna also. Swami, so many beautiful times, beautiful narrated, so many wonderful stories about Krishna. In fact, one of the stories is very heart-touching. When Bhishma takes a vow that I am going to kill all Pandavas by before the sunset tomorrow. That is what Bhishma takes a vow. He goes back after the evening. He is in his tent, very disturbed because he has taken a vow very impulsively. But Draupadi, not knowing what is going to come, what calamity is going to befall her, she runs to Krishna and asks her, prays to Krishna, Krishna, please save us. You are the only refuge to me. Krishna asks Draupadi, what happened? Why are you so sad? Says Bhishma has taken a vow to kill all the Pandavas before sunset tomorrow. Said, don't worry, I will help you. Come along with me. And Krishna walks towards the tent of Bhishma. While he is going, he tells her that just go and fall at the feet of Bhishma. Don't show your face. Those days, Swami beautifully explains again that those days the sandals, the footwear which they used to wear used to make creaking sound. So Krishna says, Draupadi, just wait. Leave your sandals because I don't want Bhishma to notice somebody is coming and see your face. So Krishna takes her sandals, wraps in his andavastram and holds it in his hand and tells Draupadi, go and fall at the feet of Bhishma. Draupadi goes and falls at the feet of Bhishma, and Bhishma says immediately, noticing that there is a lady, he did not know it is Draupadi, noticing a lady, he says, Devya Sumatri Bhava. During the day he has taken a vow to kill all the Pandavas before sunset. In the evening he tells the wife of Pandavas that Devya Sumatri Bhava. When she gets up, Bhishma is perplexed to see Draupadi there. He has said, Devya Sumatri Bhava. He knows something is wrong, well, Krishna must be behind this. Slowly Krishna walks into the tent and he sees Krishna. He says, I know Bhagavan, it is your only, your Leela only, you must have done this. Anyhow, whatever happened, happened. But I am feeling very hungry because I have not taken any of a single morsel after taking this vow. I did not know, I had committed a big blunder by taking such a vow. I was confused. I was walking up and down. So I am feeling very hungry. I think you are carrying some food in your hand. Please give me something to eat. Then Krishna unfolds his samavastam. And what happens? What he sees? The sandals of Draupadi. Swami beautifully explains, God even goes to the extent of carrying the sandals of a devotee to protect a devotee. Such a loving God is the God. That is one aspect. Then in Mahabharata, Arjuna says, I cannot fight, they are all my kith and kin, my brothers, my uncles, all are there. How can I go and kill Krishna? How can I go and kill them? Then Krishna shows his Vishwarupa. The great Vishwarupa and Bhagavad Gita is from there we have today. After seeing Vishwarupa in his complete grandeur, a god in his own self, and as a being who takes avatar on planet Earth, comes and behaves like any human being, sometimes even carries sandals, we mistake them to be a normal human being. Our Bhagavan also is no less. He would walk to each one. This is the only chetram in the entire world. Every Punya Chetra, every temple, we go to God in line. Here is the only place where God came to each and every devotee. In every temple, we offer naivedyam, we offer vastram to God. Here is a temple, here is a Viva Chetra, where God gave us the food, God gave us the vastra. To the devotees, he offered and he enjoyed it. No violence has happened in the human history. Sai devotees are very, very, very fortunate. We are all very fortunate. In Dwapara Yuga, in Treta Yuga, in all known yugas and known places, known history, our Puranas, Yajnams were performed and Yajna Purushas appeared. For Sai devotees, Yajna Purusha first appeared, then we are introduced to Yajnam. That is our good fortune. First God appeared to us, then Yajnam was introduced to us. It is not that we performed Yajna and God appeared to us. That is the great good fortune of each one of us. That is why we are able to perform such mega, mega Yajnams with so much ease, because God introduced us to this wonderful Yajnas. It is He who gave us this tradition. It is He who initiated us into this. That's why we are able to perform our mundane activities. We can go to office, we can do all our business. Still we can talk to each other. Sai devotees come together, congregate and perform such wonderful Yajnas. It is not possible. Otherwise, it is not just possible to put so many people together, so much of activity together, so many things together for a good 11 days without a break, without any hindrance, so smoothly. It is nothing but the divine presence of our Bhagavan which makes it happen. Nothing else, because the Yajna Purusha, the Lord Himself, presides over every activity that happens in Prashant Nilayam or in Vrindavan or any place of peace. Any place of peace. Just now, you know, Swami is not gone anywhere. Swami is very much here, we feel in every second. Other day, I just came here when the ATHI RUDRA was just started. We are seeing the yajna going on. Evening, I returned to my room and I was sleeping. Of course, it is not appropriate to talk about dreams and visions in Karnataka. But I did have a dream in which Swami appeared. Very strangely, after Maha Samadhi, I have not seen him many dreams, maybe once or twice. But this time, he just came and he said, this is a very personal experience, it is very individual, but why I am saying this, Swami is very much here. In fact, I shared this on the very same day with Dr. and Mr. Vinay Kumar. Swami did ask me like this, Swami is very much here. Because this again conveys how so many people, like Mr. Nalan said, lot of people require, you know, everybody talk in English, I want to talk in Kannada. In the dream, Swami is saying about ATHI RUDRA, you are having this ATHI RUDRA MAHAA. So he said, Anta Bhava Jagatanda, like that, he just inquired. He said, yes, Swami. Then he said, are you going to talk? I just shied away because I have spoken in many forums. I had attended one forum where 30,000 people attended, almost I addressed them for an hour. But today, first time, in my 44, 45 years that I am standing on the stage where Swami stood and gave his divine discourses, and thought perhaps that is the reason why he thought perhaps he should give me little courage, because I was a bit nervous yesterday and the day before yesterday. I was thinking, how do I stand next to Swami and talk? I have spoken in many other forums very easily, but think of Swami, and especially they made our life more little difficult by playing the beginning of Swami talking from here. So it's all the more reason it is reinforced the fear. But anyhow, but Swami very beautifully asked me, you know, Kojun, Kannada la chestava. He asked me, do you tell something in Kannada? I said, Swami, I do not know Kannada, Swami. Kannada, I can talk little bit in a very, you know, but I will not be able to deliver a lecture in Kannada. Swami, Kannada will be Mantravati Agala. He said, Lady, you can Kannada word in Kannada. He said, you tell something in Kannada. I actually shied away. I said, Swami, know Swami, I can't speak and I speak English. He said, no, I will tell you one four verses lying in a poem. You remember and then you tell this. I just looked straight into Swami's eyes and just kept quiet. And Swami repeated one poem, just four lines, and said, this is very simple, you tell. And Swami said this poem, asked me to repeat the poem. It's around 2:30 in the morning. Then, as soon as Swami said and asked me to repeat, I got up and wrote down in Telugu the Kannada poem. Then I repeated myself. It is very simple. Swami says, simple, chapter, good, petko, mana. He asked me to repeat. That is the beauty of the entire day. He said, Daya Tumbira Hrudaya Daiva Mandira. Daya Tumbira Hrudaya Daiva Mandira. Prema Tumbira Hrudaya Sai Mandira. Daya Tumbira Hrudaya Daiva Mandira. Prema Tumbira Hrudaya Sai Mandira. Prema Matu Daiva Bere Alla. ಪ್ರೇಮ ಮತ್ತು ದೈವ ಬೇರೆ ಅಲ್ಲ ಇದು ಸತ್ಯವಾಗು ಸುಳ್ಳಲ್ಲ ದಯ ತುಂಬಿದ ಹೃದಯ ದೈವ ಮಂದಿರ ದ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಕಂಪ್ಯಾಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಾ ಪ್ರೇಮ ತುಂಬಿದ ಹೃದಯ ಸಾಯಿ ಮಂದಿರ ದ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಫಿಲ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಲವ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಾಯಿ ಸಾಯಿ ಮತ್ತು ದೇವರು ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಅಲ್ಲ ದ ಸಾಯಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಗಾಡ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟು ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಎಂಟಿಟೀಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸತ್ಯ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ದ ಟ್ರೂತ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಟ್ರೂತ್ ಅಲೋನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಕನ್ವೇ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಮೀ ಟು ಟೆಲ್ ಇನ್ ಕನ್ನಡ ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿ ಟಾಟ್ ಮೀ ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ಡು ಯು ಥಿಂಕ್ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಹಿ ಇಸ್ ದ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಲವಿಂಗ್ ಗಾಡ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಹಿ ಸೇ ಪ್ರೇಮ ತುಂಬಿದ ಹೃದಯ ಸಾಯಿ ಮಂದಿರ ವೇರೆವರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಫಿಲ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಲವ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಸಾಯಿ ಇಸ್ ಲವ್ He is going to be there ever. He will live in that heart. He will not leave. If we even little bit show that we take one step, I will take not 10, 100 steps towards you. That is the love of our Bhagavan. He is very much here. Let us not be enamored by what happens. What we see. Lot of people, they have asked Swami about so many issues like why Kauravas were really happy. They had palaces, they had everything, but Pandavas went into forest. Then Swami has also asked questions back. He said, who were victorious in the end? It is Pandavas, 5 Pandavas and 100 Kauravas who were victorious in the end. It is 5 Pandavas who were victorious in the end. Swami also asked the reason. The Kauravas had palaces, Kauravas had comforts, but Pandavas had Krishna himself. We have God ourselves. God ourselves is with us. Satya Sai himself is with us. We will be always victorious. As long as we keep him in our heart, we have nothing to fear in this world. Lot of people may come and do, lot of people may say, thought, anything, let them say anything. But let us hold on to his feet. It is our faith which is being tested. It is we. It is our mind which is small, it is not Swami, it is not little. It is our mind which is very small with which we are seeing and we say Swami has limitation. Swami is limitless. Because we are seeing with a limited mind, we have the vision, only a limited vision. A limitless God cannot be viewed from a limited mind. It is our mistake, it is not Swami. Swami is all pervasive. Today, he is drawing more people to Prashant Nilayam than ever before. If you come and see in Prashant Nilayam, more than 50% of the Kulman Hall is filled with newcomers. Can trustees bring people, devotees to Prashant Nilayam? No. We are ordinary human beings. We also take refuge in the same field as any other devotee in the world. If we have a problem, we also have to go and convey to him only. So we cannot bring devotees to Prashant Nilayam. It is Swami who is bringing. And who can bring new devotees? Who can bring? Swami has said, if anybody has to set his step into Prashant Nilayam, I need to give permission. Unless Satya Sai gives permission, nobody can enter Prashant Nilayam. Swami time and again has said this. Today, all of the world people are coming. Then let me Japanese Swami is bringing each one of them to Prashanti Nilayam. We have nothing to fear. God is our background. Never happened in the human history that God walked, talked, so much He has given, so much. This, whenever I come to Vrindavan, my heart really, it goes into kind of numbness, because so many wonderful experiences, so many loving moments with Swami, and this Punyakshetra, He walked on this very earth, where the ritual is taking place, where we are standing, we are watching, we are going to perform, we are going to, whatever we witness, every bit of this sand, every bit of this earth, what we are in vicinity, is sanctified by Bhagavan's holy feet. He has walked to each and every corner of Vrindavan. As a kid of maybe 6-7 years, I have seen Swami, just like that, walking about, hardly 4-5 of us, students and elders who are running here and there. There's no time, there's no darshan time, whenever you could feel like you would walk about, and that is the Vrindavan. Because whenever Krishna is in Vrindavan, he is relaxed. It is, Swami used to say, Prati is my office, Vrindavan is my home. So we are celebrated at Ratnakar at his home. What a great fortune that we all have. It is a very long time to come onto the dais when Shiva Parvati is so beautifully decorated and seated waiting for Kalyanasram. I don't want to take much time on this very auspicious and divine day. We thank each one from the Saranakas and each and every group which participated in this wonderful MAHAA, and especially the Karnataka, this youth group from led by Vinay, and the Karnataka Sangam under the leadership of Dattappa, and of course there are other states also got involved, and it just shows the kind of enthusiasm to participate in Swami's activity. Anything to do with Swami is a uniting. Today we all feel connected, because any activity that happens here draws our heart to this place. Because just one factor, it is Bhagavan and His love. So many people are seated here. It is not only Yagnams happen in many places, but here it has got a different flavor altogether. That divine love of Bhagavan Sri Satya Sai Baba, and under the able leadership and very, very learned guidance of Sri Manjula Dikshit Garu, this all the priests who have participated, we thank you very much. And whatever groups, whatever I could name, those who are people who have behind the scenes also would have done a lot of work. I think we thank each one of them. And above all, as a fellow devotee, I would like to place my gratitude at the lotus feet of Bhagavan for granting us such a wonderful blessing to reconnect with Him. Swami, please keep us always stay connected to your lotus feet. Please keep us always under your loving care. Jai Sai Ram. Thank you very much.